Hi everyone, this is Veronica and today we are going to discuss Maternity Leave Incentive Scheme. Even last year Maternity Benefit Amendment Act also came, so we will discuss that also. If you have any queries, you can message me on Instagram or Facebook, and even the PDF you'll get on my Facebook profile and or my Telegram group. So guys, if you're preparing for any government exams or pen drive courses are also available, you can contact on these numbers or you can visit our site for additional information. So now, what is the relevance of this topic in our exam? See, Maternity Benefit Amendment Act 2017, it was scheduled from 1st of April, it was applied. So even questions from this can be asked, and we'll discuss this also in detail, because now there is a high probability that in exam questions from the features of this act could be asked in prelims, in MCQs, for any, you know, any government exam. Now from mains point of view, paper 2 governance, this portion consists, this part questions could be asked, and even from GS1, women related issues, there are many women related issues, questions can be asked from that section also. Now let's see these questions. Which of the following statements are correct regarding Maternity Benefit Act? You can read this. Statement 1 is, Maternity Benefit Amendment Act 2017 has increased the duration of paid maternity leave available for women employees to 26 from 12 weeks to 26 from 12 weeks. Second statement is, the amended act has mandated creche facility for every establishment employing 50 or more employees. The act is applicable to those women employed in factories, mines or shops or commercial establishment employing 10 or more employees. So you can select the right answer. Now the next question is, as per Maternity Benefit Act, the maximum period for which a woman shall be entitled to maternity benefit shall be, you can select the correct answer and write in the comment box. And third question is like very similar to the first one, but there are a few changes. Now why is this in news? Basically to encourage the employers, especially in the private sector, to implement the extended 26-week maternity leave that was that amendment act was passed in 2017. To boost this scheme, the Labour Ministry has planned to refund the 7 weeks worth wages of women workers, but there is a ceiling that is of 15,000 per month could be refunded in each case. Now see, what is the Maternity Benefit Act? Now what happened, basically this scheme, which was this amendment act, which was established last year in 2017, it was going well with the public sector, but the private sector, the whole burden was on the private employers. So to encourage them, the government has brought up this scheme. Now we will discuss in detail what is the Maternity Benefit Act 1961. So basically this applied to the establishment which were employing 10 or more than 10 persons. So to all such establishment this act applies, and then the main purpose was to regulate the employment of the women, to bring the women into the employment sector. So the act was amended through Maternity Benefit Act 2017. We will study the main features of this act, as the question, high probability is that the question could be asked. Now what are the main features? Earlier the maternity leave was 12 weeks, but it was increased to 26 weeks through this amendment act. Now the 12 weeks of paid maternity leave to mothers who are adopting a child below the age of 3 months would be given maternity leave to. Earlier no such provision existed, and even for the third child the entitlement was 12 weeks. The further they reduced it to 6 weeks if the women wanted a fourth child. Okay, even the commissioning mothers, that is the mother, the ladies who will become mothers through surrogacy, they also get a leave for 12 weeks. Now it is also mandatory for the employers that if they have female employees, 30 to 50 female employees, they need to provide creche facility in close vicinity, that is up to 500 meters or in the office, whichever is the nearer to the ladies, and the mother can visit the child 4 times during the working hours. And even the option of work from home is also available in this case, and but that is not mandatory. It depends upon the mutual understanding of the employer and the female employee. Now, what we'll do, we'll compare the 1961 Act and the Amendment Act of 2017, and we'll see what are the differences. The paid leave was for 12 weeks. Now, the paid leave is for 26 weeks. Leave, you can apply for the leave not prior to the 6 weeks from the due date, but here the time is 8 weeks before the due date you can apply for the leave. Here there was no provision for the adoptive and the commissioning mothers, but here you get the leave for 12 weeks maternity leave. There is no option for flexible work hours, but here you get the option to work from home. So here's how the comparison between the 1961 and 2017 goes. Now we'll discuss the benefits and the criticisms of this act. So there are a lot of benefits. Can you think of any criticism? If you can, please write in the comment box. But before that, we'll discuss the benefits of this scheme. Now see, it is a progressive step for our Indian society, as 1.8 million women in organized sector will be benefited. There would be work-life balance, and mother can take care of the child. And as India has high mortality rate and high maternity death rate also, that could be reduced. We can take care of the health of the people also. Sorry, I moved the slides. Yeah, okay. Now, as WHO recommended that the breastfeeding of children for first 24 weeks should be mandatory. Now we are falling in line with that also. And it will also reduce the gender inequality at work, and it will bring down maternal and infant mortality rate according to WHO. Such schemes can benefit that also. Now what is the possible criticism for such schemes? So when last year this scheme came up, lot of criticism also came. Like, you are asking the creche facility, it will increase the financial burden on the employer. Next, the people, the employers, will prefer to hire male employees rather than the female, because the financial burden on them is increasing. And even it is ignoring the 90% women who are working in the unorganized sector. Third, one important thing is here that you are forgetting about the fathers. What about fathers? Do they don't have any role in the upbringing of the child? So what the basic stereotype exists in India about the child care being exclusively a women's responsibility, we are totally excluding the paternity leave from this ambit. So even it is, next point is, even it is discriminative for adoption, as it says only the leave will be granted only to the women who adopts a child below 3 months of age. So what about the other children? Nobody will adopt them. So these are the possible criticisms of this scheme. Now just see what is the ground reality of implementation of this scheme. What they have seen that in private sector, the in contract job, they are not hiring the women, and even if women is in a contract job, what they do, they break the contract giving flimsy reasons, useless reasons. So it is not encouraging the women employees anymore, as people in private sector are not hiring them. However, this is quite good. There's good response from the public sector, because the financial burden is on the government only, government itself. But in private sector, whole financial burden comes upon the employer. They terminate the contracts. So this is proving to be deterrent for the female employees when they ask for leave, right? So that is why the government has proposed this incentive scheme, that 7 weeks wages would be reimbursed, and there's a ceiling of 15,000, and the budget outlay for the scheme is ₹400 crores, right? Now, what are the expected outcomes? What will be the benefit of this incentive scheme? That the women will get an equal access to employment, and about safety and a secure environment will also increase. And after that, women shall continue to bear the major share of household work as well as the child care. And the workplaces will now become more responsible towards the working women, and they will help them to strike a work-life balance. Now, there are certain rumors which are surrounding this news. What are those rumors? First rumor is that the scheme has been approved and notified, but the Labour Ministry has said they have clarified that this scheme is still in process of obtaining necessary budgetary grant and approvals from competent authorities, so it is still not notified. Another big rumor is that it will be funded from labour welfare cess. However, the government has said no such welfare cess is there. Now, where this news of cess all came in between? Now, see, there is a cess, and there is a cess exists known as BOCW, that is building and other construction workers cess act. It provides collection of funds for construction workers by states and union territories, but this fund is exclusively for building and construction workers. It cannot be diverted. This fund cannot be diverted for other schemes or any other such programs. That is not permissible under this act. So this is whole rumor. This is totally false news that has been clarified by the Labour Ministry. Now, what is the conclusion? The conclusion from this is that there is a long list of barriers that women face in accessing employment opportunities. The risk of exploitation in the informal sector, the lack of wage parity, such kind of problems still needs to find a solution. But for informal sector, government has again brought in certain schemes. I will just give you a hint about those schemes. One is like PM Matru Vandana Yojana. And other is Janani Suraksha Yojana. So government is helping the people in informal sector also by giving them some financial help, like 5,000 would be given here and 1,000 would be given in Janani Suraksha Yojana for institutional deliveries. Government is doing a lot, but the problem lies in implementation. Next big conclusion, what we can take out from this discussion is that India's problem is not about bringing back women after childbirth, but the main thing is that we have still a lot of responsibility to bring women back into, not back, but we need to bring women into workforce at the first place, because only 25% women even in the urban area are working. We need to bring them in work area at the first place. That should be our priority, but definitely we welcome such steps, such schemes. It should be encouraged. Now you can practice this question. Discuss the salient features of Maternity Benefit Amendment Act 2017. It is conceded that the bill will provide women with much needed work-life balance. You need to critically analyze this question. Now there are questions like critically analyze, discuss, explain, elucidate. These all words hold different meanings. I'll make a video on answer writing also. Then I will explain the meaning of these. But right now you can practice. So the correct answer is all are correct here. All the statements are correct. For next is 26 weeks. I already told you it has been increased from 12 weeks to 26 weeks. And for this only 1 and 2 correct. Statement 3 is wrong because here it is written 24 weeks. However, it is 26 weeks. Thank you. If you have any queries, you can contact me on social media. You can follow me on Instagram and Facebook. Thank you.